Zach Bogosian, Messina, New York, a defenseman for the Peterborough Petes. My favorite NHL player is Chris Chelios. He's just a warrior, and he'll do anything to take to win. Watching him, you know, when he was younger, obviously now he's a bit older, but he's still hanging around. So, but you know, he is a warrior, and that's the way I like to pattern my game after is him. And you know, he likes to compete, and so do I. I think my strengths is you know, skating and my strength. I think I like to play defense, but I do like to play offense too. So I like to throw a little all around in there, and you know, I'm not afraid to get a little nasty and play physical. So I think. You know, it's all about having fun, too, and I think I do have a lot of fun playing for Peterborough.
Zach is a big player, plays defense very big. Perhaps to the surprise of a lot of scouts, he's been overlooked on a lot of Team USA international selections, and soon he'll be a franchise player for a National Hockey League team, even at this tough defense position. What sets Zach apart is the combination of his skating ability and his size. Whereas there's some other bigger, taller defensemen who have to grow into their body, Zach is right there, fully proportioned, and ready to make that step into the NHL very quickly.
Growing up in Messina, New York, Zach got to spend quality time with a future Hall of Famer after he won the Stanley Cup.
Well, when Scott Stevens won the Stanley Cup in 2000 in New Jersey, I got a chance to spend 5 days with him at his cottage, and I saw him raise the Stanley Cup right in front of me, and you know, I saw Conn Smythe, I saw everything. So it was pretty fun just to go there for 5 days, because I played with his nephew when I was younger, and I was the only non-family member there. I felt a little out of place, but you know, I got treated very well, and it was a fun experience.
As if spending time with one Hall of Famer wasn't enough, Zach had a rare chance to learn his craft directly from another Hall of Famer, the great Raymond Bourque.
My first year, it was a little slow. I was young and small, and I was in an old team, so I didn't get to play too much. But I came into the, you know, my 10th grade year. It would have been my draft year for the OHL, and Ray Bourque's son, it was his first year, and he was there for a volunteer assistant coach, and he got on the ice with us probably 3-4 times a week, and he just, you know, just the little things, nothing to put too much on a, you know, a 15-year-old, but he, you know, he taught me a lot of little things about coming into the zone late and being deceptive when you're coming up the ice. So it was good to have him around.